Hi, sixth graders, we're back and we're going to talk about how we write numbers as fractions, decimals, and percents. We'll be given one of those numbers and we have to decide how to do it as the other two. Okay, so let's look at it. Okay, on my first one, I gave us 4%. Okay, so if I have 4%, I need to figure out how to write that as a fraction and a decimal. Okay, so I always like to do the fraction first from that. Okay, because I know I have one number, so that's my numerator, 4. And since I only have one number, I can put it over 10. Okay, this isn't reduced, but that's where we can start. 4% is 4, and since there's one number, I'm going to have 10 on there, 10. Okay, and then I can reduce it, which you need to. We can divide both by 2, and we get 2/5. Okay, so start out by putting it over 10 or over 100, because if you have two numbers, we'll put it over 100. So if that was 40, we would put it over 100 and then reduce. But since it's 4, we put it over 10 and reduce. Now, as a decimal, now, that's why it makes it a little easier if we have this to go to the decimal, because if we read this, it's 4/10. So we know this 4 is going to go in the tenth spot. So we put our decimal. The tenth spot is the first spot after the decimal. And we have 4/10. So if we have 4%, 4/10 is the decimal, and 4/10 reduced to 2/5 is a fraction. Okay, let's say I give you my fraction. And my fraction is 17/100. Okay, so I need the percent. That's pretty easy. That's the easiest one. If it's over 100, we just take that top number and it's a percent. Okay, it has to be over 100 for that to be the percent. Think about it like this. If this was your test grade, your percent, you got 17 out of 100, your percent would still be 17%. Okay, hopefully that's not our test grade, but there you go. Okay, now to write this as a decimal, we said as long as it's over 10 or as long as it's over 100, we can. So I have 2 zeros. If we can't remember the 100th place, I know those 2 zeros can tell me how many spots I'm going to have after my decimal. So my second one is my 100th place, and I fill this number in, going out to my 100th place. So 17/100 is written as 0.17 or 17%. Okay, so let's try another one. Okay, if I have the decimal this time of 0.25 or 25/100, okay, and I want to write it as a fraction, I have 2 spots in my decimal. That means I'm going to have 2 zeros after my 1 down here, 100, and then I'm going to put my decimal number on top, which I can then reduce, and I can divide those by 25. So that's actually 1/4. There's my reduced. So, but if I think about this, if I got 25 out of 100 on my test, what percent did I get? You got it, 25%. Okay? So guys, remember, your fractions, if you've got them over 10 or 100, it's easy to do the decimal and the percent, okay? But remember, you may work from the tens or the hundreds, but you need to reduce your fractions as well. All right, sixth graders, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye.